Patient CC was brought to the ER by ambulance with a 3-day history of fever, chills, and cough, and 1 day of diarrhea and abdominal pain. Today, he is confused and lethargic. On exam, he is febrile, cool to touch, O2 sat 84% on 100% by non-rebreather, abdomen distended, and overall, he looked septic. CC was admitted to the ICU with severe sepsis. Sepsis is the presence of infection associated with a profound systemic inflammatory response. Severe sepsis means there is also evidence of organ failure. Septic shock means that the blood pressure doesn't respond to aggressive fluid therapy. This systemic inflammatory response syndrome is called SIRS and is present when at least 2 of the following criteria are met. Temperature greater than 38 degrees Celsius or less than 36 degrees Celsius. Heart rate greater than 90 beats per minute, respiratory rate greater than 20 breaths per minute, and white blood cell count greater than 12 or less than 4. Mortality with sepsis or severe sepsis is 20 to 50%. Older age, immunosuppression, poor prior functional status, infection with a resistant bug, prolonged need for blood pressure support, and progressive organ failure are associated with worse outcomes. Sepsis is a clinical diagnosis and may be associated with any kind of infection. However, the most common sources are lung, intra-abdominal, and urinary tract. In addition to aggressive resuscitation, sepsis management requires prompt initiation of appropriate empiric antibiotics, as delayed therapy has been associated with increased patient mortality. Empiric antibiotic selection should consider the following: presumed site of infection, available microbiology information, known colonization, resistance patterns, and chronic illness. Given the minimum margin for error, broad-spectrum antibiotics are warranted until culture results are available. Once a bug is identified, narrow or tailor antibiotics for the remainder of the course. There is no evidence that combination therapy is more effective than single-agent treatment. For CC, the presumed infection is severe community-acquired pneumonia, and a reasonable empiric regimen is ceftriaxone plus azithromycin. And in flu season, oseltamivir can be considered. If CC has chronic obstructive lung disease with frequent courses of antibiotics, a broad-spectrum agent could be used instead of ceftriaxone for broader gram-negative coverage. Treatment duration will be determined by the source of infection and infecting organism. For example, community-acquired pneumonia with strep pneumo, treat for 7 days. If despite extensive testing, a pathogen is not found, try to limit course of treatment to a week. Key messages: don't delay starting appropriate broad-spectrum antibiotics. Target the presumed site of infection when possible. Tailor therapy when culture information is available. And duration of therapy should be based on source of infection and infecting organism.